Okay, so we're back to face the final 55 minutes of this endurance race on the Portugal circuit. Just before the break, Mr. Gon went out of track and lost to two positions.
Narrowly avoiding Cox when he rejoined. Adrian Smith worked his way back up to 7th.
I think we just got back to his view when he was doing an overtake on the hairpin.
We've just been discussing how dark it is at that hairpin.
Whoa! Johnson might lose two positions if you're not careful. Oh. Wow, 10 slappers back on 8.
He is. Yeah, Tanks has pulled out a 4-second lead over the break.
So, considering the strategies we've seen so far, will we be seeing one more pit stop or two?
Seems to be about every 25 minutes, I should think two. There comes someone. Gone. Gone, trying to get past Cox. And, yeah, Smith and Tank Slapper really do want to find a way past Johnson. Here comes Buskirk on Tank Slapper.
Holy!
That was a long way back.
We're seeing overtakes out of nowhere here. Whoa! How's this rolling?
Wow. He's on his roof now. He's been put back on his wheel. Carries up.
Wow. He went flying up ahead.
Randy Kim has caught up to Gon and Cox.
So I believe Cox is leaving this race. Actually, Osborne. Wow, so many battles. And it's not even for first.
Smith's right with Johnson as well. Tank Slapper's dropped quite away after Buskirk overtook him.
Doesn't surprise me that would fight him anymore, would it? Wouldn't it?
The distance he came back from was crazy. Wow. Is that Gon holding all that up? I think it is.
And yeah, that's the interior view, so you can see how dark it is.
Smith on Johnson. Nearly runs in the back of Kim. You can't even see the barriers around here to the track.
So Smith actually overtook Johnson.
Yep, into the first corner.
This could easily be battle for first, considering how it started. It was the Tank Slapper Johnson Smith, wasn't it?
I think so. Although there's an 8 second gap to the third. Is that
Smith on the outside, I think?
Yeah, he was just going around the outside. Here comes Kim on gone. Nope. What's going on?
Smith on the outside!
Oh,
wow!
Everyone bunched up and he took great advantage.
And we know how dangerous that hairpin is. Smith was on two wheels earlier. Al split the car. And there's still about 50 minutes remaining.
So Cox, gone, Smith, Kim and Johnson. And
huge pack of cars there.
Yeah. I bet Smith's going to make a move on gone here, he's very close. No, nobody moves.
Ooh, Johnson!
That was Johnson on Kim, wasn't it?
Yep.
A lot of marbles on the track. That's another thing they've got to worry about, looking for those marbles in the pitch black.
I believe
it's gone. Sapper's got Kim. Hasn't Smith dropped back from gone? He has, hasn't he?
I'm not sure, every turn is different right now. You see a car far behind and then on the next turn and it's right on its bumper.
Oh, there's a tyre in the middle of the track that Cox and Gunner just ran into.
Smith is really close to Gunner.
House has retired the car after that rock. Engine damage apparently. Here comes Smith. There's a nut. Buskirk and... Is Buskirk? No, Tank Slapper's just got... I'm all confused now. Tank Slapper's up to 7th. Cox has pulled away from... God. Smith right with Osborne. Nick Smith, that is.
Smith looks quite a lot quicker than gone.
Yeah.
He's going for it. Oof!
Ooh, close the door that.
Yeah, I think Smith was concerned of those barricades and barrels. They pretty much act like a barricade.
Yeah. It looks like the old nearly spin coming out of that hairpin though.
Really hard to control the car, really bumpy as well.
Especially when you got no chance control either. Smith in the slipstream and gone. He needs to pull out. But he hasn't done.
They are both catching up on Cox though.
Yep. Smith has... Nick Smith has dropped back from Osborne. I noticed they're using the curbs a lot here, a lot more here than they did at Malaysia. They've really caught up Cox now.
Smith, and Cox.
No, he's not made it. Gone back down the inside.
Wow. And they're really close to Cox now. They're having to slow down really badly.
Yeah. It's gonna let Buskirk right up behind Smith as well.
Oh, this is battle for third. Actually. Whoa!
It must be so hard for the drivers to see that the car's coming. Because, I mean, I should think they look back and just get blinded by the headlights. I think Gon's shaping up Cox here. He's looking in either direction, but.
Whoa!
Right in the back of it.
Wow. That was a nasty bump.
I think Gon's starting to get a bit frustrated to me, I can't.
Well, that should certainly wake Cox up.
Smith's right behind Buskirk now. Look how quick Gon's catching Cox up down this track. He's got to make the move. No, it's Smith. No. Smith can't find a way past Buskirk.
Nick Smith is closing the gap on Osborne.
Again, he was right with him earlier and then he dropped off again.
I think Osborne might be losing time with everyone right now. Cox was 9 seconds away and he's now 8.8.
The closest battle right now is between Smith and Buskirk and Johnson.
So far, 5 retirements. Powell, Bartlett, Tintu and Hurley by accident. Kelly House with engine failure. And Austin Dunn with a do not finish.
I didn't notice 4 valid retired.
Had an accident apparently. In fact, that's pretty recently, that was on lap 45.
2 laps ago then.
Cox is catching up on the guys ahead. He's still quite far, but he's catching up. He's 7.666 away now.
Smith's really close to Buskirk. He's all over his gearbox looking for a way through.
And he is through.
No.
I think he tried that place earlier and then realised the barrels were there. So he had to abort mission. And was he on two wheels again around that hairpin?
I'm not sure. Smith might be about to go for Buskirk. Nope, still no way through.
And Johnson wants a piece of the cake. I believe they might be going for a pit stop any time soon.
I should think they will be, yeah. Wow! Johnson caught Smith and Buskirk up a lot on that one.
Well, I guess Buskirk is just trying to defend himself and Smith is just looking where to overtake him.
Both cars are sliding all over the place. Osborne's pitted.
Well, if he's not stuck in traffic, he had a pretty decent lead.
Cox has caught Smith up, I think. There he is. So welcome to everyone that's just joining us. I'm Matt and Danny's joining me as ever, and this is the 2 hours of Portugal GP with just 40-ish minutes to go.
So far we've had a really exciting race with lots of overtaking both the front and the back of the pack.
And Buskirk is in, so Smith will go through to take third. Second even, because Smith and gone and, yeah, lots of people pitting basically.
I believe we'll be seeing Osborne soon.
Where is Osborne? He's 15th, just going through the hairpin.
Everyone
in front of him pitted, apart from tanks like Yin, Smith and Cox. The earlier pit stop seems to be working out fairly well for Osborne so far.
There he goes. Across the stop.
Fifth then, we're just waiting for everyone else to pit.
There goes Smith and Busker, followed by Grouper, Johnson, Smiley, whoa! Really close there.
Smith and Cox are in.
Back on Randall's car. Nobody ahead of him. Nobody behind him.
It's going to be a pit stop race between Smith and Cox, I think. Cox is off the jack. There goes Osborne. Back into the lead. And Smith's gone. What's happened to Cox? He's still sat in the pit lane. He finally leaves. He's lost an absolute ton of places. Let's put Buskirk third, Adrian Smith fourth. Oslo Grouper is 5th, with Boris Johnson 6th, Ronald Lee is 7th, and Smiley 8th, and then Randy Kim and Sanchez round out the top 10.
And we are assuming we might pit again right before the end of the race. Just about we can go for another 30 minutes without stopping for fuel.
Sanchez is looking for a way past Kim.
And I believe... is that the moon? Because part of the track seems a bit brighter.
Not sure. So you got Buskirk being followed by Smith and Grouper. And there could be a position changes going on for third.
There goes Grouper.
Down the inside of Smith. Buskirk's caught Nick as well, and he's going for it. Wow. Nick had to get out of the way quick there. Grouper's caught up with him there.
Grouper's running out of the front bumper.
Smith's caught up with these guys as well. Grouper looking for a way through. Smith driving around the outside again. Grouper knows that Smith's right behind him and he wants to get past Smith.
That hairpin and the turn after that is just evil.
House will definitely agree with you.
Indeed.
So Adrian Smith has dropped back from Grouper a bit. I think Grouper really wants to find a way to pass Smith though. He's looking and darting around all over the place.
I think Johnson's thinking about the same thing on Smith.
Yeah, he's caught up, hasn't he? So we're almost three rounds through this championship. What do you reckon so far?
Well, so far, Adrian Smith is the most unlucky on the first race. But apart from that, I suppose he's been the most regular driver so far.
Is that Ronald Lee? No, it's Johnson on Garupa, I think. I'm not sure. Smith on Busker, he's through. Someone else back there.
Lee on Johnson.
And Smith got past Garupa at some point.
I suppose it was a sunshine.
A lollipop. So Smith's looking at Buskirk now for third. Smith has had a pretty good recovery drive after that off earlier on in the night. Ooh, Smith having to run a bit wide there. The sun's starting to rise.
Whoa! I believe that was Garupa on Smith.
It was. Yeah, I think the sun's starting to rise, isn't it?
I do believe so. I didn't notice the tight was beginning to get slightly brighter in some areas.
Make a few drivers' lives easier. Because you must start to get mad just seeing headlights all night, really.
Wow! The way they take that hairpin.
Hope the suspension's up to scratch. So it's Buskirk, Smith and Garupa right next to each other. And then Johnson's right with Lee as well.
It is real.
Another late lunge. Oh, someone's off. Who's off? Buskirk's off. He's ripped the front off of that.
Yep.
So Lee is now hunting down Smith. Osborne's got himself a nice 7 second lead, and then there's another 7 seconds between Smith and Garupa.
Yeah, unless he makes a mistake or there's a mechanical failure, he should be in for an easy win. Well, not an easy win obviously, but when there's 25 minutes remaining out of a 2 hour race.
It was actually Osborne that won the first race, I just checked that. Only by 3 seconds. So, Smith retired in the first race. And then in the second race, he won by 11 seconds.
Yeah, I do believe we would have had a nice battle between Smith and Osborne.
Fort Bell has retired in the last two races after his second place in the first race. so kind of gone downhill for him. Buzzcoat's still going, but his race is over now. He was on for a good finish. It's taken 2 seconds out of him this lap.
Has anything happened to Randall? Or has he just lost the pace?
Well, we're in the last 25 minutes. I suppose he's trying to make sure the tyres and fuel make it.
I do doubt it very much. Although, the more fuel he can save, the longer he can stay on track and then make a really short stint.
Yeah, I mean, we're looking at like 5 minute stint towards the end of it.
More than likely. Unless somehow someone can save enough fuel. Bits of car in the track there. Rupert and Smith are catching up on Nick.
Smith, yeah.
Wow, they're really close now.
Nick's actually lost a second this lap.
Indeed. But still, Rupert and Smith are catching on Osborne overall.
Yeah. They were, well, it came 7 seconds about.
So have Randall and Nick been pushing too hard? They might have worn out the tyres too early.
We'll find out in about 10 minutes time, I should think. 10-15 minutes.
I don't think the group is going to wait that long.
Oh my god!
Oh my god! Oh wow!
That's such a shame for Grouper.
Ooh.
That thing trying to get past there, was it?
Wow!
So Adrian Smith is now right up with Nick.
Adrian Smith has climbed up to third place.
He has. I mean, he's how far off? 8 seconds on the lead. I think that's too much in just 20 minutes.
But wow, what just happened to Grouper?
Grouper's just ran away at great results, so that's what's happened. Too impatient to get past Nick and, yeah, throwing it all away.
Smith.
Just 20 minutes to go.
Wow.
Ooh. Nick went to cover that very early.
I mean, Grouper had plenty of time.
He's still going, but that's got to run up to his confidence.
balance a bit more patience on Nick.
So far.
But you never know with Alan Smith.
So Buskirk and Grouper, who were both running strong early on, have gone off and just completely ruined their good race. Team Boss at number 5 is going to be pretty angry with Grouper, I think, though. Just throwing away some good points there, and here comes Smith.
Is he going for it? Ooh. Grouper is already going on sync.
Doesn't seem to damage the car.
Well, he didn't lose his front bumper. Or had he lost that already?
He's lost that for a while. It's probably what caused him to roll or something.
You lose a lot of grip.
Well, Lee's caught up and so's Johnson. To Smith and whatnot.
Smith's. Ooh, Lee taking the lead, Smith.
Yeah.
It's a bit of car still on that. On that corner before the hairpin.
Osborne's got a 9-second lead now.
Well,
surely nothing can stop him.
This is perfect race for him. He's just driving along while everyone else is just battling. And I mean, that's pretty literal. It is a battle.
Smith on Lee and Lee on Smith. But nothing happened.
Not just yet, not just yet.
Amazing to see the cars are so close together after 2 hours of racing. Well, nearly 2 hours. Smith on Lee. Lee's covered the inside. Who's going around the outside? Nope, can't get around. Smith seems to collect that outside line.
And he seems to be pretty fast around there, doesn't he? Losing on Nick, though.
Nick's gone.
Is Nick catching up on Randall though?
7.9, so... Got Lee Smith and Johnson right next to each other.
We see a lot of cars with damage. I mean, it is an endurance race after all, but...
Yeah, you're not supposed to damage the car. if it was a longer race, it might have patched the car up, but in just 2 hours, you can't afford to lose that much time, really.
Nick can't get away that much now.
Grouper's just pitted and he's on his way out now.
Early pit stop for him. It might be a good idea if he managed to get out of traffic.
Lee's caught up to Nick again. Adrian's dropped back from him. Where's Grouper though? Oh, he's long gone.
Yeah, but remember he's already pitted.
I was wondering if he'd be in the way or not.
Oh. Is Randall just round this corner?
Nah, he's a lot further away than that. So you've got Lee, Smith and Johnson all with Nick at the minute. And there goes Lee. Lee's through. Is Smith is going to be as well? No. Seeing a lot of good overtakes tonight.
Yeah, indeed. And in unpredictable places as well.
There's just 13 minutes left.
We'll be seeing pit stops anytime soon. If they are planning to do a pit stop, that is.
Adrian Smith looking like he could be up for a move here. Boris Johnson's caught up quickly at the end of the straight. He's going for it. Is there room?
Ooh.
There is.
So,
whoa.
Smith, Nick's off. That's damaged the car badly there. Yeah, he's stopped.
Yeah, he stopped. He's gonna retire. Yellow flag.
10 minutes before the end of the race.
Wow.
He'll be kicking himself.
And that was a very good race from his side as well. So, Alan Smith goes up a position.
Yeah, he's up to fourth now. Sing on, Kim. Yep, Nick's retired. With engine down. Field's spread out now.
We did see that under the race, if I remember correctly, up to the final 5 minutes. And then they all got together again.
Although, Cypher is pitting. So ignore what I was about to say. Oh, Jimenez is caught up with Finkel.
Just over 10 minutes remaining.
Adrian's caught Boris again.
And I believe Duncan is catching up on Lee.
I think he is. Osborne's got 7 second lead still.
It all depends on the last pit stop. I mean, if you choose the wrong time, you might be stuck in traffic, and then that's race over for you. Especially
pits. Don't want to go in pit too early either. Osborne's in. So is Lee. Johnson carries on, so does Smith. Kim's coming in. Singh. This is crunch time now. What can Smith and Johnson do? Because this could easily be for the race win here.
Well, they basically want to lose as less time as possible. Even if they don't overtake each other.
Problem is, if they're trying to overtake and defend and whatnot, they are going to lose time.
They might lose position. Randall's out of the pit. Seems he's going to be out without traffic.
Yep. That'll help him out a load.
No traffic ahead of Randall, no traffic behind him.
I've not seen Smith try to overtake on that hairpin after he nearly rolled it.
Randall is actually ahead of Lee.
Indeed. Ooh. Oh. Smith's taking the lead because Johnson's pitted. Chua is coming in, so is Buskirk and Finkel. Smith's going very long here.
Maybe save enough fuel. Remember, Smith was 10th or 11th at some point.
Yeah, I mean, he's got 7 minutes left. Tank Slap has moved his way up to 2nd. 3rd, because Yin's just overtaken on the inside.
I mean, Randall's been pushing the entire race. He might have used more fuel than the rest of the guys. Randall is up to 5th now.
Johnson's out of pit.
Cox battling with Tank Slapper. As we see, Tank Slapper's suspension.
And Tank Slapper got past Cox. Or was he already ahead?
As far as I know, he was already ahead. I think.
Smith in. Osborne's. Where is Osborne? I think he's coming up to the hairpin. Yeah, Osborne's coming up to the hairpin, so. I think this might have been a bad idea for Smith. I mean, he's got an 18 second lead, but it's not going to be enough, I don't think. Yin, Tank Slapper and Cox will be past. Oh no, they're pitting.
Johnson's on the hairpin. Just come past it. Remember, Johnson and Smith were battling position.
There goes Osborne.
Johnson pitted one lap earlier than Smith. He's just he's on the main straight.
Smith leaving the pit.
Oh, this might be close.
It came up to 3rd. And here comes Johnson. They're both off the ice limited.
Oh wow.
So he's going to be so close.
Johnson's ahead. Hit him earlier, gave him the position back.
because there's 5 minutes left of this pretty exciting race.
It's been an epic race so far. Let's see what they've got in store for the last 5 minutes. Well, less than 5 minutes.
4.5. Seems right with Smith.
He is 6 seconds behind Osborne.
And then it's Kim, 13 seconds behind Osborne.
And I believe Johnson's catching on Kim.
Finkeltura and Grouper are right with each other.
And I think we're going to see a group of four in a bit. Seeing Smith, Johnson and Lee. Kim, sorry.
We've only got 3 minutes left of the race.
Singh getting really close to Smith now. So it's Osborne, Lee, Kim, Johnson, Smith and Singh. And then Jimenez, Finkel, Tua and Cypher on the top 10. And 1 minute remaining.
I think Osborne's got this in the bag now. Final lap, I should think. Martha to stick the ready bunching up now.
Well, for the final place on the podium. Johnson getting really close, and the rest of the guys are getting really close as well. The time has just reached zero.
Yeah. They're running out. out of time, they're going to have to make a move soon.
Osborne heading...
Blake Smith, ooh.
Osborne taking... Last time he goes through that hairpin.
Smith has just got Johnson.
Smith... He's taken fourth. Can he get third? I highly doubt it now, there's not many overtaking points.
Here comes Osborne. Down the start, finish straight. He's your winner of the 2 hours of Portugal. Ronald Lee follows him home in second. It's going to be Kim in third. With Smith chasing him down all the way. And then Boris Johnson, Stacey Singh take fifth and sixth.
Jimenez. I don't see a checkered flag.
There was one, don't worry.
I'll take that for granted then. There was one, don't worry.
23 finishes in the end. From the 30 that started.
Osborne heading back to the pit after a marvellous race. Started out the back and managed to get to the first position.
Great drive. Smith's probably a little disappointed after he chucked it off in the middle of the night.
Johnson's staying out for another lap. I'm not entirely sure why.
There's a few cars that are still out.
But yeah, we've had a really interesting race. A lot of excitement.
Well, this was the 2 hours of Portugal GP. Thank you for joining me again, Danny, and thank you to everyone that came and watched us. We shall see you again for round 4, where we're back at Mills Metro.
Thank you for watching, and good night. Thank you.